Hi students, today's experiment is common emitter characteristics. The aim of this characteristic is to study the input and output characteristics of the transistor in common emitter characteristic. Okay, required components are BC547 NPN transistor, two resistors, 1 kilo ohm resistor and 100k resistor, and multimeter, voltmeter and one more voltmeter. Okay, here two voltmeters for input characteristics. We have required two voltmeters and one ammeter. Okay, this is circuit diagram for common emitter characteristics circuit diagram. Here we are connecting common emitter characteristics input characteristics. For input characteristics, we have to connect positive supply of the input to the base and negative to the emitter. And here next second channel, positive supply is connected to the collector and negative is connected to the emitter. Here input and output common is emitter terminal. Here emitter, base, collector. Emitter is common to both input and output. That's why it is called as common emitter configuration or characteristics. Okay. Now let us connect this circuit diagram. As for the circuit diagram, here we don't require VCE. We don't require IC. Okay. Why? Because we required only in the tabular column VCE, VBE and IB. Okay, VCE means output voltage, and VBE is input voltage, base to emitter voltage, and IB is input current. So for this circuit you have to short this current IC milliamps. Okay, IC you have to short it and connect direct RC to collector. Okay, next start the connection. Okay, so here this transistor, emitter, base, collector. I am connecting here different nodes, emitter, base, collector. For emitter, base, collector, here emitter, base, collector. So first to supply to positive, we have to positive connect some other one node, and negative is connected to the grounded. So I am assuming this node is grounding. Okay, from supply positive to 100k resistor, one terminal of the 100k resistor. So this is 100k resistor. I'm connecting one of the terminal to the supply of the positive, and another terminal is connected to some other node. Okay, next to IB ammeter, we have to connect ammeter here. So I'm assuming this multimeter is ammeter, and positive terminal is connected to the second terminal of the resistor, 100k resistor. I'm connecting positive to second terminal of the resistor, and negative terminal is connected to negative of the ammeter is connected to the base of the transistor. Base of the transistor is, base is this one. I'm connecting base of the transistor. Okay, and here input side we have one more voltmeter will be there. A voltmeter positive is connected to the base of the transistor. So voltmeter positive is connected to base of the transistor, and negative is connected to the ground. Negative is connected to the ground. So input side is connection is over. Next to output side. From output side you have to connect positive supply is connected to the connected positive is this one. Positive is connected to select any one node. From one node to connect resistor, 1 kilo ohm resistor. 1 kilo ohm resistor here, 1 kilo ohm resistor. Connect one of the node to positive terminal of the supply, and second node is connected to the direct collector. Collector. Here IC is shorted. Okay, I don't require here. Okay, and negative terminal is connected to the supply, negative is connected to the grounded. And last one is emitter. Emitter is directly connected to the grounded. Okay. One more. In the output side, you have to connect voltmeter. That is VCE. VCE. Positive is connected to the collector terminal. Positive is connected to the positive terminal of the collector, and negative is connected to the grounding. Okay. So connection is over. Next, go to the procedure of this circuit diagram. tabular column is this one, for this is input characteristics of the common emitter characteristics. Here VCE output voltage will be constant by varying the output channel, second channel of the DRPS. I'm assuming second channel is the output and first input is first channel, assuming. Okay, let's start the on the supply DRPS. Okay, on the multimeters, keep it in ammeter side, so it is act as ammeter. I am using this voltmeter purpose, so keep it in voltmeter mode, and here it is also voltmeter mode, keep it in multimeter. Okay, so IB always in, you will get microamps, you have to connect, keep it in mode in 200 microamps mode. Okay, next procedure is keep the voltage VCE voltage, first VCE voltage keep it in constant voltage, and then first you have to go for 0 volts, next time you have to go for 5 volts, like that. Okay, for VCE 0 volts, and next vary the input voltage VBB, by varying VBB you have to measure the values of VBE and IB. Okay, so now I am setting constant VCE is output side by second channel, so minimum 0 means we are getting here 0 volts, so it is 0 for constant voltage VCE 0. Now varying the VBB, by varying VBB you have to measure VBE and IB. Okay, like up to 0.91 volts you have to increase step wise 0.1, 0.1, 0.1, next you have to increase 1, 2, 3, like that. For 0.1 volts you are getting VBE is 0.1 and IB is 0 amps. Okay, next to for 0.2 we are getting VB is 0.2 and current IB is 0. Next to 0.3 we are getting 0.27, approximately 0.3. So 0.3 and current is 0.1 microamps. Next 0.4, current is, voltage is 0.35 and current is 0.2 microamps. For 0.5 we are getting 0.41 VBE and IB is 0.5 microamps. For 0.6 volts 0.46 and current is 1.3 microamps. For 0.7 volts VB is 0.48 and current is 1.9 microamps. For 0.8 voltage VB is 0.49, current is 2.9. For 0.9 VB is 0.5 volts, current is 3.6 microamps. For 1 volt VB is 0.51 and current is 4.8 microamps. For 2 volts, now increasing step wise 2 volts. For 2 volts, 0.54 VBE and current is 14.3 microamps. For 3 volts, VBE is 0.56 and current is 25.6 microamps. For VBB 5 volts, 0.58 is the VBE and 45.3 microamps IB. For 6 volts, for 5 volts, for 6 volts, VBE 54.9 microamps. For 7 for 7 volts, 0.6 VBE, 65.3 microamps. So like that we have to increase like that up to 10-15 values and draw the graph. Next go for VCE 5 volts. So first we have to minimize the input voltage, minimize to 0 volts, and by using VCC, we have to constant voltage is VCE 5 volts. By varying VCC, we have to constant fix the voltage VCE 5 volts. VCE 5 volts. Okay. Okay, 5 volts. I'm fixing the 5 volts. Again, we have to increase input voltage VBB and vary the input voltage by like 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 up to 1, and after 1 volts, we have to increase 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. And measure the values VBE, IB. Okay, next again 0.1 volts, 0.1 current is 0 microamps. For 0.2, 0.18 current is 0. For 0.3 again 0.27 and current is 0.1 microamps. For 0.4, 0.34 VBE, current is 0.2. For 0.5, voltage is 0.44, current is 0.3. For 0.6, 0.53 VBE and IB is 0.7. For 0.7, 0.58 is the VBE and current is 1.5 microamps. For 0.8, 0.59 VBE, current is 2.1 microamps. For 0.9, VBE is 0.60, current is 2.8 microamps. For 1.61 and current is 3.5 microamps. Next we have to increase step 2, 1, 2, 3 like that. So 2 volts, for 2 volts VBB, VBE is 0.66 and current is 13.9 microamps. For 3 volts, for 3 volts VBB, 0.66, 23.7 microamps. For 4 volts, 0.66, 0.666, current is 36.7. For 5 volts, 5 volts VBB, we are getting 0.667 VBE, 44.2 microamps. For 6 volts and 7 volts, for 6 volts, 0.668 and 54.5 microamps. For 7 volts, 7 volts, 0.669, 63.1 microamps, 0.669. From this table, you have to draw the input characteristics of the graph by using Vc is 0 volts between Vb and Ib. Input voltage Vbe and input current Ib. These are the input characteristics values. Okay, now we have to minimize the supply voltage and minimize the 0 volts for input and output also, and switch off the multimeter. Okay, next we have to go for output characteristics. Output characteristics, in the output characteristics we required IB, VCE, IC. So in the output characteristics, IB input current is constant and output voltage VCE versus IC. Graph will be in between VCE versus IC. So in the circuit diagram you have to IB constant, IB current is constant, and output we have to measure VCE, output voltage VCE, and IC, output current IC. So from this circuit diagram I have connected this circuit on red board. Here previous input characteristics we have VBE, we have removed this VBE, and extra I have connected in the series with collector terminal or resistor RC2 on ammeter. Here ammeter I have connected in series with resistor, 1 kilo ohm resistor. Okay, remaining is same, only I have removed VBE and connected here ammeter. Okay, next to in the procedure is we have to constant input voltage by varying the VBB. By varying input voltage VBB, you have to constant the IB value like 10 microamps and like 20 microamps. You have to take it any value, 10, 20, 30, 40, like that. So I am assuming here 10 microamps and 20 microamps. Okay. For fixing the, keeping this constant value, by varying the output voltage VCC, we have to measure the VCE and IC. Here VCE and IC, this one. I here IB. Okay. Let's do the practical on the supply. Keep it in. This is IB purpose, so I am keeping in microamps. IB is always in microamps, so you are connected IB in ammeter in 200 microamps mode. And this is IC purpose. IC is always in milliamps, so I am keep it in 20 milliamps mode. And this is used for VCE, VCE output voltage, so I am keeping voltage mode here. Okay, let's now by varying the input voltage you have to fix the input current IB. Okay, that is 10 microamps. Okay, 10 microamps. Okay, this is 10 microamps fixing the input current fixing constant. By varying the output voltage now, you have to measure IC and VCE. Okay, like VCE output characteristics, you have to increase stepwise 1, 2, 3 volts like that. Now, for IB 10 microamps constant, VCE, I am varying VCC 1 volt. For 1 volt, for 1 volt VCC, I am getting VCE, and IC is 0.91 microamps, sorry milliamps. For 2 volts, VCC 2 volts, voltage is 0.13 volts, current is 1.84 milliamps. For 3 volts, VCC, voltage is 0.2 volts and current is 2.76 milliamps. For 3 volts VCC, you got voltage is 0.21 and current is 2.79 milliamps. For 4 volts, 4 volt VCC, voltage is VC is 0.97 and current is 3.05 milliamps. For 5 volts, voltage VC is 1.93 volts and current is 3.09. For 6 volts VCC, VCE voltage is 2.98 and current is 3.12. For 7 volts VCC, VCE is 3.91 volts and current is 3.16 milliamps. For 8 volts VCC, 4.92 volts VCE and current is 3.18. For 9 volts VCC, 5.97 VCE and current is 3.21. For 10 volts VCC, 6.88 VCE and 3.25 IC. For 12 volts, 8.95 and current is 3.33. For 13 volts VCC, 9.87 VCE, 3.33 IC. For 14 volts VCC, you got 10.85 VCE and IC is 3.37. Last you have to take it 15 volts. 15 volts VCE, VCC 15 volts, VCE is 11.88 and current is 3.40. So here we are getting 3 point something is constant. Output voltage, output current is constant, that is 3 point something, approximately 3 volts, 3 milliamps. For next you have to go for IB 20 microamps. First you have to minimize the VCC voltage. VCC voltage 0. Next you have to increase IB to 10 microamps to 20 microamps. Constant voltage and constant current 20 microamps. Okay, 20 microamps. Again, you have to repeat the same procedure. For output side, you have to increase VCC like 1 volt, 1 step by, and you have to measure the values of VC and IC. So, same 1 volt VCC. 1 volt, you got 0.07 VCE and current is 0.94 milliamps. For 2 volts VCC, 0.09 volts and 1.88 milliamps. For 3 volts VCC, 0.11 VCE and 2.90 IC. For 4 volts VCC, for 4 volts VCC, 0.13 VCE and 3.90 IC. For 5 volts, for 5 volts VCC, 0.16 VCE, IC is 4.91. For 6 volts, VCC, 0.21 VCE, 0.21 volts and 5.82 milliamps IC. For 7 volts VCC, for 7 volts 0.65 VCE and 6.43 IC. For 8 volts, for 8 volts VCC, 8 volts VCC, 1.51 VCE and 6.53 IC. For 9 volts, for 9 volts VCC, 2.51 VCE and IC is 6.62 milliamps. For 10 volts VCC, voltage is VCE is 3.44 and current is 6.70. For 11 volts VCE, VCC 11 volts, VCE is 4.38 volts and current is 6.78 milliamps. For 12 volts, 12 volts VCC, 5.32 volts VCE and IC is 6.88. Here we are getting constant volt, current is 6 point something. Okay, next to up to 13 volts VCC, 6.22 and 6.99 current. And for VCC 14 volts, for 14 volts, voltage VCE is 7.11 and current is 7.08. For VCC 15 volts, VCC 8.04 volts VCE, 7.19 IC. So this is the output characteristics of the tabular column. From this table you have to draw the graph VCE versus IC for IB equal to 10 microamps and IB equal to 20 microamps. From the input characteristics table you have drawn the graph for input characteristics for VCE equal to 0 volts, VCE equal to 5 volts. This is VCE equal to 0 volts, but this is for VCE equal to 5 volts. This is VCE equal to 5 volts graph and this is VCE equal to 0 volts graph. From this graph you have to calculate input resistance RI. Here you have to locate two points on this curve. I am locating this one point, and from this here I am locating this point. From this point you have to draw a line, straight line to the x axis and y axis. And here I have drawn this one, and from this two I have drawn to y axis. Okay, here in the x axis we have taken VBE voltage, and y axis we have taken IB in microamps. In x axis one unit equal to, or 1 centimeter equal to 0.1 volts, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. In y axis I am taking 1 centimeter equal to 5 microamps, 5 times 10, 15, 20, 25, like this. Okay, here I have drawn this two straight lines, in here this point and here to here on line. This difference is V V delta VBE. Okay, delta VBE. And so here, how many values will be there? How many lines? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. 1 unit equal to 0.1 means 5 subdivisions will be there. So, it is 0.05 volts. 0.05 volts. Here, I have drawn this line and here to here. Okay, here 26 microamps, here 4.5 microamps. So, this difference is delta IB. Delta IB equal to 26 minus 4.5 microamps. That is 21.5 microamps. Okay. From this input characteristics, we have calculated delta VB and delta IB. From output characteristics table, this is output characteristics table. From this output characteristics table, we have drawn output graph. Okay. In the graph, x-axis we have taken VCE voltage and y-axis we have taken IC in milliamps. 1 unit equal to 1 volts and y-axis 1 unit equal to 1 milliamps. Okay. From this output characteristics we have to calculate delta VCE and delta IC. From this value we have to calculate R0, output resistance. Okay. So I am locating two points on the one of the graph. This is 20 microamps, this is 10 microamps. Okay. Here we have 10 microamps, this is 20 microamps values. From these values I have drawn this graph for 10 microamps, this is for 20 microamps. We have to look at two points on the graph and line, draw a straight line to the x-axis and y-axis. X-axis and y-axis. This difference is, we have to calculate delta, this difference is delta VCE. Delta VCE equal to 7 minus 4, that is 3 volts. Here in the y-axis, here delta IC. Delta IC equal to 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. So total 0.3 milliamps. Okay. From this graph, output characteristics, we have calculated delta VCE and delta IC. From these values, delta IC, delta VCE, delta VBE and delta IB, we have to calculate all the remaining values. From the VBE, delta VBE equal to 0.5 volts, 0.05 volts. And delta IB equal to 21.5 microamps, delta VCE equal to 3 volts, delta IC equal to 0.3 milliamps. From this, you have to calculate input impedance, HI equal to RI equal to delta VBE by delta IB. You have to insert these values and calculate this one. Your reverse voltage gain equal to HRE equal to delta VBE by delta VCE. And output admittance equal to 1 by HO equal to R0 equal to delta IC by delta VCE. Okay, in forward current gain, HFE equal to delta IC by delta IB. All these values you have calculated from the graph. So you have to insert and calculate.